One of the most important features of DCI's Falcon locating systems is frequency optimization. Today, we are going to show you how to properly set up your locating system so you can efficiently use it next time you're out in the field. Please read and understand your operator's manual for more information. There are a few things you want to do before starting your pilot bore. This includes scanning the area for active interference, assigning bands, pairing, and calibrating the transmitter to the receiver, also referred to as scan pick pair. When setting up your locating system, make sure there are no batteries in your transmitter and no active transmitters within 100 feet. To start scanning your intended bore path for active interference, go to your main menu screen and select the transmitter selection menu. Select the transmitter selection icon to pick the desired transmitter. You will now see at the top of the screen there is an FT5 indicating the current transmitter type. After doing this, select the frequency optimization menu and press the blue arrow to start the scan. When the frequency optimization is complete and all noise bars appear, you can now start to walk your intended bore path. While walking the entire bore path, observe the bars and their maximum noise reading markers. It is best practice to return to the point of the bore path with the highest noise and rescan to optimize bands in that area. You will want to select the two bands that are the least affected, which are the lowest bars on the graph. Now that you have decided what two bands you want to use, it is time to assign them to the up or down bands. It is best practice to assign the down band to the band you intend to start the bore with. Assign the other band to the up band. Insert the batteries into your transmitter with the positive side first and install the end cap. Then click to confirm the assignment of both bands by pressing the green arrow. This will take you to the transmitter pairing request screen. Align both IR ports within 2 inches from each other and click the trigger on the receiver screen. After successfully pairing both devices, click the trigger one more time and you will be prompted to calibrate the up band. Make sure that the calibration is done in an environment free of active and passive interference and that your transmitter is inside the drill head on level ground. Using a tape measure, measure 10 feet from the center of the drill head lid to the inside wall of the receiver and click the green arrow. After successfully calibrating this band, the above ground range will appear. Confirm that calibration is correct by taking several measurements. Then click exit to return to the locating screen. To calibrate the second band, change the frequency on the transmitter. There are 4 ways to change the frequencies on the transmitter. For this demonstration, we are going to use the tilt method. Without rotating the drill head, lift it approximately 100% or nearly vertical and wait 10 to 18 seconds, then return it back to level ground. Your receiver should lose all transmitter information, indicating that you are no longer receiving the up band. Next, select the down band on your receiver, hold the toggle to the right to open the transmitter selection menu, and select the down band. Select locate mode to return to the locate screen and verify you see clock, pitch, and signal strength. The red triangle in the roll indicator shows calibration is still needed for this band. Go to your main menu and select the calibration icon and select 1-point calibration. Repeat the calibration process for the down band.
Now you know how to set up your locating system on your next job site.